MPs on the Parliamentary Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises today quizzed officials of the Uganda Land Commission on how Kampala International University, that belongs to businessman Hassan Basajja Balaba, acquired 14 acres of the Chibuli Nsambya Railway land, partly won by the private local investors who are lined up to be compensated after losing their land in the Nakawa Naguru estate where they had earlier been issued titles in error.
Kampala International University came on late, and it seems these people were supposed to get this land. They were now ignored and added it up because it is the difference almost. So these 14 acres that were given to Kampala International University, there was some collusion and connivance.
Kampala International University was not one of those proposed to receive land. But eventually, even by the cabinet memo, but then eventually it was allocated land. How did that happen?
There was a presidential directive of 29th September 2010, where the commission was directed to allocate 20 acres of land in the Zambia area. The allocations of the commission were done in May 2011. So these allocations did accommodate Kampala International University.
KIU was not even in the cabinet directive of the 13 investors approved for compensation, including Janet Kobusinge, Charles Chimera, National Library, Islamic University, and Nakawa Disabled Vocational Training Institute. Others are Quakers, Church of Uganda, and House of Dawa. But the commission told the committee that they acted on a presidential directive of the 29th of September 2010.
There was a cabinet directive saying those that were meant to be given Naguru Nakawa estate land and they did not get it, they should now be given this land belonging to Uganda Railways Corporation. And there's a list. Now, some names are not on the list, but then eventually they get to receive land. And again, we hear that the land that was given to them eventually served other purposes. KIU is an example, because they were given 14 acres of land.
When Uganda Railway Corporation transferred land to you, it had a mother title. It had a title, one big title, of maybe 100 acres.
I understand the question. Right.
And then on that land, you started subdividing for the beneficiaries, 12 acres, 7 acres, 4 acres, 14, isn't it? Isn't it?
Yes.
Exactly. Now, that is what we want. Could you please give us that title and then the subdivisions?
However, the committee queried the authenticity of the presidential directive after discovering that the annex was forged and directed Uganda Land Commission to produce the original copy of the directive to clear suspicion.
Some of these letters, we need to look at the original letters. They have been using these letters to cover up. Because when you look at the matter, how does Kampala International University come in? Petition over what? What happened? And even when you look at the purpose, construction of staff quarters, executive apartments, student whatever, chair, we need to look at the origin of this letter, whether it is from the president.
Do we have originals? Because these are photocopies. Do we have originals that we can get and ascertain about these directives? Because you know, such letters have been forged before, you are aware, by different people, different entities, and so we are suspicious.
It is not only KIU that obtained railway land under controversial circumstances. Color Press Services, which was allocated 2 acres at a premium of 120 million shillings, and Fair Play Catering Services obtained 3 acres at zero premium.
We should have gone back to cabinet and informed cabinet of the dilemma. From the records, unfortunately, this procedure was not followed. And from the side of the commission, I'd like to apologize.
MPs established that none of the 13 beneficiaries paid premium, and yet these investors deviated from the purpose to which they were allocated the land. Others went on and sold off the land.
Someone getting land, 1.6 hectares, in the central business district of Kampala, does not pay premium. I don't understand how it works.
In this, you say, in accordance with the PPP agreement signed with government, are all these people that benefited from land, from this land, do they have those PPP agreements with government? Because we want to see the terms, whether the terms have allowed them to sell off that land to Arena.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.